Namaste students, during the lockdown period you might have seen Mahabharata serial. In that Mahabharata serial there comes one scene. Krishna Kurukshetra dalli Arjunanige bodhaneyana maduttane adanna aramaneyalli kutkondu Sanjaya Dhritarashtranige helutane. So Sanjaya live telecast anna comment maadi ಧೃತರಾಷ್ಟ್ರನಿಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾನೆ. ಹೌ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್? ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ಟ್ರೇಲಿಯಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಭಾರತ 2020 ಮ್ಯಾಚ್, ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರುವ 2020 ಮ್ಯಾಚನ್ನು ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಎಟ್ ಹೋಮ್. ಹೌ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್? ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಫ್ಯೂ ಫಿನಾಮಿನಾ. ಸೊ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಕೂಡ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಆಗೋದು ಯಾವಾಗ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ವೇವ್ಸ್, ಸರ್ಟೇನ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್. And already you have studied the characteristics of waves, frequency, wavelength, and how the wave propagates from one point to other point, and what actually the wave is. Idella kuda neevu last classes alli odidira. Today in this class we are going to deal with a new concept and a very important concept about waves. That is superposition principle. Yaudu? Superposition principle. Superposition principle. So before going to state this principle, that is superposition principle, let us see two examples. So ee eradu examples ana now nodidre we can easily understand what this statement is or what this principle states exactly. So let us consider two examples one by one. The first example, let us consider two pulses, one with 2 cm amplitude. I hope you know what is amplitude. Amplitude is the maximum displacement of the particle about its mean position. So the displacement or the maximum displacement of this pulse is 2 cm. And let us consider one more wave or one more pulse with an amplitude 1 cm, and this 2 cm pulse is moving towards the right side and this 1 cm pulse is moving towards the left side. Let it be at t equals 1 second. So at t equals 1 second we have considered two pulses with amplitudes 2 cm and amplitude 1 cm. Both are moving in the opposite directions. Now at t equals 2 seconds what happens? So at t equals 1 second ಇದು ಎರಡರದ್ದು ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 1 ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್? ವಿ ನೋ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವೇವ್ ಮೂವ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ 1 ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಟು ಅದರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಏನಾಯಿತು, 1 ಸೆಕೆಂಡಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಇದ್ದರೆ 2 ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ಸಿಗೆ ಬರಬೇಕಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಈ ಕಡೆ ಮತ್ತು ಇದು ಆ ಕಡೆ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ನಾವ್ so 1 cm wave, 2 cm pulse, and this is 1 cm pulse, and of course this is moving towards right and this is moving towards left. This is at t equals 2 seconds. What happens at t equals 3 seconds? At t equals 3 seconds, so 1 cm, 2 cm pulse 1 centimeter pulse. So the two are moving towards each other. Now at t equals 4 seconds, at a particular point, these two pulses will meet. So nanu ikadeinda hogta idene, aa kadeinda inondu yaro bartha idare. So time jaasti aada hage enaitu, nan ee kade move aagta idene, aa particle kuda ee kade bartha ide. At one particular point and at one particular instant of time. So heeg bartha ide, idu heeg bartha ide, hatra 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 bandu, at one particular point and at one particular instant of time enaitu, illi collision aagtide. But in case of waves, let us see what happens. Now at this particular point, this pulse comes and the displacement of this particle due to the first pulse will be 2 centimeter, and simultaneously the second pulse will come and the two pulses will meet at this point. Already due to this first pulse there is a displacement about 2 centimeter, and now 1 centimeter pulse will meet the particle, meet this wave. Then what happens? The particle displaces by 3 centimeter, Now at t equals 4 seconds and at one particular point, the displacement of the particle becomes 3 centimeter. At t equals 5 seconds. So at this particular instant of time, at this particular point, enaitu, the two will meet and the amplitude becomes sum of the amplitudes. Now at t equals 5 seconds, the 1 centimeter pulse will move towards this and the 2 centimeter pulse will move towards the right. So here what happened? At one particular instant of time, that is at t equals 4 seconds, at one particular point the two pulses meet and the resultant displacement of the particle at this particular point is the sum of the displacements of the individual amplitudes, correct? Individual waves in the absence of others. So e wave, e pulse irade idre idra displacement 2 centimeter aagta ittu. E wave irade irta idre adra displacement 1 centimeter aagta ittu. So when these two waves meet at this particular point, the amplitude or the displacement of the particle becomes maximum, which is the sum of the individual displacements. Let us consider one more example. Now let us consider two pulses with same amplitude 1 centimeter, but one pulse is moving towards right and one pulse with amplitude minus 1 centimeter is moving towards left, and this is the situation or the positions of two waves or two pulses at t equals 1 second. So iga navu eradu or different side alli ondu positive side alli hogta ide inondu with negative amplitude, but the amplitude value is same, 1 centimeter. So the two pulses are moving like this at t equals 1 second. At t equals 2 seconds, what happens? This pulse will move towards right and this pulse will move towards left. At that time what happens? They come close to each other, this is the position of pulses at t equals 2 seconds. At t equals 3 seconds, what happens? Now, at this particular instant of time, at one particular point, these two waves will meet. These two waves will meet. So, when these two waves with amplitude 1 centimeter and one more 1 centimeter but in the opposite direction, what happens? This 1 centimeter will cancel this 1 centimeter. So, we get a wave like this or a graph like this. At t equals 4 seconds, this pulse will move towards right with an amplitude 1 centimeter, and this second pulse will move towards left with an amplitude 1 centimeter. So, here at this particular instant of time t equals 3 seconds, what happened? This wave met the second pulse, the first pulse met the second pulse, so that the net effect was cancelled by each other, because this is plus 1 and one more wave is having minus 1 or in the negative direction. Okay, means here the net effect is equal to 0. Means here also, at one particular instant of time and at one particular point, when the two waves meet, the net displacement of the particle is the sum of the displacements due to individual waves in the absence of others. So, yeradu wave galu meet aadaga, ondu particular instant of time alli, ondu particular instant of point alli, net displacement enagirtade anthelidre, sum of the displacements due to, sum of the displacements due to waves in the absence of other. So, ondu wave inda illi 1 centimeter displacement aitu, inondu wave inda eshtu displacement aitu? Minus 1 centimeter. So, net displacement eshtu aitu? 1 minus 1, net displacement is equal to 0. And these two are the examples to explain superposition principle. So, when the first wave meets a point, the particle vibrates about its mean position and its amplitude becomes equal to the amplitude of the first wave. At the same time, that is simultaneously, one more wave will meet that point. So, at that point enaitu, first ge ondu position anna tagonditu. So, due to the second pulse, the particle will take one more position. So, position na mele position anna tagolutade depending on the direction of the displacements. So, we call this as superposition. Position na mele position. So, eshtu number of pulses, eshtu number of waves, depending on that the particles will vibrate about their mean position. That is why we call this principle as superposition principle. Then how to state this superposition principle? The statement is, when two or more waves meet, when two or more waves meet, the net displacement, the net displacement at a point, net displacement at a point at a particular instant of time, at a particular instant of time is the sum of the displacements due to the waves in the absence of others. When two or more waves meet, the net displacement at a point, here this is at a point anta helidre elli meet aagtade a point, therefore we call this, we can call this as at the point, and at a particular instant of time is the sum of the displacements due to the waves in the absence of others. This is the statement of superposition principle. So when two or more waves meet, then the net displacement at that point and at that particular instant of time is the sum of the displacements due to the waves or due to the individual waves in the absence of others. So eradu athwa adakkinta jaasti wave galu ಒಂದು ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮಲ್ಲಿ ಮೀಟ್ ಆದಾಗ ಆ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇದ್ದು ನೆಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿರ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದು ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಇನ್ ದ ಆಬ್ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿರ್ತದೆ ಅಷ್ಟರದ್ದು ಸಮ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ನೆಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ದ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಡಿಷನ್ So here vector addition yak helutteve ant helidre here we are adding the displacements. So displacement is a vector quantity, therefore this sum is nothing but the vector addition of the displacements due to individual waves in the absence of others. Now when two or more waves meet, what happens? We get one more wave, that is we call that as resultant wave. Let us derive the expression for resultant wave when two waves meet or when two waves superpose each other. Let us consider two waves with displacements y1 is equal to a sine kx minus omega t and one more wave with displacement y2 is equal to a sine kx minus omega t plus 5. You have to consider two waves with same frequency and amplitude. y1 is equal to a sine kx minus omega t and y2 is equal to a sine kx minus omega t plus 5. Here both the waves are moving in positive x-axis and 5 is the phase difference between the two waves. So two waves with phase difference phi and amplitude a, frequency nu, moving along positive x-axis. This much you have to consider. According to the principle of superposition of waves, the net displacement at a point at a particular instant of time is the sum of the displacements. So y1 is the displacement due to the first wave in the absence of second wave, and y2 is the displacement due to the second wave in the absence of the first wave. Therefore the net resultant displacement y is equal to y1 plus y2. Let us find out the resultant displacement. So, y is equal to y1 plus y2. y1 is a sin kx minus omega t plus y2 is a sin kx minus omega t plus 5. So, idan en maadbeku naavu add maadbeku. Iga id eradralli yavudu common ide? Amplitude is the same. So, amplitude A is common. Therefore, we can take A outside. So, then what we get? Y equals A into. What are the remaining quantities? Sin of kx minus omega t plus sin of kx minus omega t plus 5. So, A into sin of kx minus omega t plus sin of kx minus omega t plus 5. Now, see the quantities present inside this bracket. Sin of kx minus omega t plus sin of kx minus omega t plus 5. Now, this is of the form sin A plus sin B. Sin A plus sin B. Sin A plus sin B. Have we solved sin A plus sin B? The formula is 2 sin A plus B by 2, 2 sin A plus B by 2 into cos A minus B by 2. So, sin A plus sin B is 2 sin A plus B by 2 cos A minus B by 2. Now, we can simplify this using this formula. Therefore, what we get? Y equals A into 2 sin A plus B by 2. 2 sin A plus B by 2. So, A into 2 sin, what is the value of A? Kx minus omega t plus, what is the value of B? Kx minus omega t plus 5 divided by 2 into cos of A minus B by 2. So, cos of Kx minus omega t minus of B. What is the value of B? Kx minus omega t plus 5 divided by 2. So, using sin A plus sin B formula, you have to expand this. Y equals A into 2 sin of kx minus omega t plus kx minus omega t plus 5 divided by 2 into cos of kx minus omega t minus of BH2 kx minus omega t plus 5 divided by 2. Let us simplify this. So, y is equal to A into 2 sin, let us simplify this, kx plus kx, 2kx divided by 2. How much will get? Kx minus omega t minus omega t minus 2 omega t divided by 2. So, minus omega t. plus 5/2. So sine of kx minus omega t plus 5/2 into cos of kx minus omega t minus kx minus of minus plus omega t minus 5. Is try to this kx will cancel with this minus kx. This minus omega t will cancel with this plus omega t. Ili minus ide bracket olgade minus omega t ide. So minus into minus plus omega t and omega t will cancel. So minus 5/2. But what is the value of cos of minus theta? Cos of minus theta is cos theta. Therefore, this cos of minus 5/2 becomes cos of 5/2. So let us rearrange the terms. Then y is equal to 2 into a into cos of 5/2 into sine kx minus omega t plus 5/2. So y is equal to 2a cos of 5/2 into sine of kx minus omega t plus 5/2. Let us further simplify this. Y is equal to, let us call this 2a cos of 5/2 term as r, that is the resultant amplitude, into sine of kx minus omega t plus 5/2. This is the equation of displacement. We got the equation of the resultant wave as y equals r into sine of kx minus omega t plus 5/2. This is similar to simple harmonic motion wave equation. But here the wave has initial phase 5/2 and the amplitude is equal to r, where r is equal to 2a cos of 5/2. So now resultant wave with the equation eno y equals r into sine of kx minus omega t plus 5/2. So idu simple harmonic motion idu wave equation ige similar agide, but here with the initial phase 5/2 and the amplitude of the resultant wave is r is equal to 2a cos of 5/2. Now if phi is equal to 0, that is if the two waves which are going to superpose have same phase, andre in phase phi equals 0, then cos of 5/2, cos of 0/2 becomes cos 0, cos 0 is 1. So when the two waves are in phase, then the resultant amplitude r is equal to 2a. So this is the maximum possible amplitude. Now if the two waves are out of phase, if the phase difference between the two waves is equal to pi, at that time what happens? When phi equals pi, cos of 5/2 becomes cos of pi by 2. Cos of pi by 2, cos 90 degree is 0. Therefore, the resultant amplitude reduces to 0. So if the two waves are in phase, that is phi equals 0, the resultant amplitude will be maximum, and if the two waves are out of phase, that is if the phase difference is pi, then the resultant amplitude will be minimum, that is R is equal to 0. We have derived these conditions by considering two waves with equal amplitude A. So now consider madida erdu wave idu amplitude eshtagittu A. Now if we consider two waves with different amplitudes, so bere bere amplitude idu waves ana consider madidre, what happens to the value of amplitude? So A be the amplitude of the resultant wave and A1 be the amplitude of one of the waves and A2 be the amplitude of the other wave. So two waves ana consider martteve, ondradu amplitude A1, inondradu amplitude A2, and theta be the phase difference between the two waves, then the amplitude of the resultant wave is A is equal to A1 square plus A2 square plus 2A1 A2 cos theta. So if the two waves with the different amplitude superpose each other and if the two waves have the phase difference theta, then the value of the amplitude of resultant wave is root of A1 square plus A2 square plus 2A1 A2 cos theta. So this is about superposition of waves. Where we use this concept, superposition of waves or superposition principle, you might have seen interference of light or interference of waves, and when we listen to music, we listen to beats. So in case of standing waves, beats and interference, we use superposition principle. We use superposition principle to explain the interference pattern of waves, beats and stationary waves. Interference, about interference you are going to learn in the second PU. Now we'll study about beats and stationary waves, but to learn about beats and stationary waves, we need one more concept called reflection of waves. In your lower classes already you have studied about the reflection of light waves and refraction of light waves, and I hope you remember the laws of reflection and the laws of refraction. So nimge exact aagi reflection andre enu, refraction andre enu, adra laws ella yavdu ant heli already neevu 10th standard alli odidira. So illi adakkinta swalpa jaasti naavu study maartteve reflection of waves. Till now you have studied about progressive wave. So one particular direction alli move aagta irutade, waves hogta irutade, progressive wave ant helidre. But reflection of waves, when this reflection of waves takes place, when any object reflects, so naniga ee chalk piece anna board ge hit madidre, here this behaves like an obstacle or boundary. So idu illige hit aagvaga this chalk piece will exert some force on this wall and the wall will exert some force on this chalk piece. So result aagi enaitu, this chalk piece will bounce back to the same medium. Actually this is called reflection in general. Then how the waves reflect or how the waves refract. So in case of wave, the wave reflects as well as there is refraction in case of waves. But for you, in your syllabus, you have only about the reflection of waves. So when any wave meets a rigid boundary, when any wave meets a rigid boundary, let us imagine this as a boundary, this as a boundary, and one wave is propagating like this. Now if there is no boundary, one vele nan idanna consider madade idre, this wave will travel like this, correct? Yavude boundary illa, sumne hogta irutade. But if one boundary exists in the path of wave, what happens? So ee wave illinda heeg bartade, illi bandu ee interface anna meet aagtade, but further move aaglikke aagudilla because this is a rigid boundary. So illige banda wave enaytu, it must reflect back to the same medium, correct? Illinda bandu adu reflect aagbeku. Then how it reflects? There are two conditions. The first one is if the boundary is rigid, if the boundary is rigid. Now let us consider a rigid wall. Rigid wall. So eshte waves bandu wall ge hit aadre kuda wall anna enu madlik agudilla, wall anna cross madlikke agudilla. The wave should reflect. So let us consider a pulse. Pulse is moving towards the wall. Now after some time interval, this pulse will hit this rigid wall or rigid surface. When this pulse hits this rigid boundary, what happens? We know wave carries energy, so it exerts some force on this rigid boundary. In turn, this rigid boundary will exert some force on this pulse, and this rigid boundary generates a wave. This rigid boundary generates a wave, or since here we have considered a pulse, this rigid boundary generates a pulse in the opposite direction. So when the pulse hits the boundary, the pulse exerts some force on the rigid boundary or the rigid wall. In turn, the rigid wall will exert force on this pulse, and at the point of contact, this wall generates a pulse which moves in the opposite direction, or this incident pulse is reflected but in the opposite direction. So the reflected wave will move like this. So you have to consider a pulse which is moving towards a rigid wall. When the pulse hits the rigid wall, it will exert some force on the wall. In turn, the wall will exert some force on the incident pulse, and a reflected pulse is generated which moves in the opposite direction. Now at this point of contact of wave with the wall, the phase difference is pi, and at this point there is no net displacement because the particles of the rigid wall are rigid, they are not free to move. So at this point there is no displacement. This is about reflection of waves. When the waves meet rigid wall. If the waves meet an elastic medium. So let us consider one elastic medium. So when the waves meet an elastic medium, part of the wave is refracted and part of the wave is reflected. Let us consider only the reflection part. A pulse moves towards the elastic boundary, and after some time it hits the boundary. But here, when the pulse hits the elastic medium or a free boundary elastic medium, the particles of this medium will vibrate with maximum amplitude, and this boundary will generate a reflected wave which moves in the same direction as that of the incident wave. And here there is no phase difference between the incident wave and the reflected wave, and here the amplitude will be maximum. So these two are the concepts of reflection of waves: when it hits rigid body and when the waves hit elastic medium. So when the waves hit rigid medium, the waves will get reflected back with a phase reversal or with a phase difference of pi, and at the boundary the net displacement is zero, or the amplitude is equal to zero. But if the waves meet the elastic boundary, at the point of contact the amplitude will be maximum, and this boundary will generate or reflect the waves in the same direction as that of the incident light. So this is about reflection of waves. So here only reflection of waves takes place, but in this case, if the surface is elastic boundary or it is a free surface, then part of the wave is reflected and part of the wave is refracted. But in both the cases, the reflected waves and the refracted waves obey laws of reflection and laws of refraction. In the next class, we are going to study the applications of superposition principle and this reflection of waves. Thank you.